Jen. this is Brian with Brian. A Y. Wait, with a Y. With a Y. Brian.
I'm Mike. This is with Mike.
Mike with an I. Okay, so today what we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit more about the bridging, because the Chun Q is about learning to bridge, right? And I already discussed this in a previous video before. If you want to get in and spar in the ring or in the cage or do sparring matches with your friends or something like that with the equipment, you have to learn to bridge. Okay? That's part of the distance fighting. If you can't develop that skill, then you're not ready to spar. Okay? But on the street, like I said, the street is different. You do not necessarily need the footwork. It's not so important. Why? Because I don't need a bridge. Why? Because if we're in a fight in the street, and Brian's he just spilled beer all over me, right? Or I accidentally spilled beer on him. This actually happened to me before. I actually spilled some beer on someone, right? Oh, okay, now he wants to get all chested. So, what do? You don't have to do anything. One, he's gonna come up to you, right? He's gonna be all macho, come up to you and put his hands on you. I don't have to do anything. I don't have to bridge. He's gonna bridge for me. And if he doesn't, right, and he's getting all tough, then just use Hawkins' method. Hawkins says, just talk bad about his mother and his sister and just flip them off, right? And the guy's gonna come right up to you, right? Oh yeah, right? So when he comes in, there you go. That's your bridge. You just bring your hands up now, right? So, but in the ring, okay, we're sparring, right? He's a trained fighter. I'm in there to practice my skills in the ring, okay? He's not gonna come up to me just like this, right? No, he's not. He's a smart fighter for the ring. He's a smart competitor. That means he's not gonna allow me to get close to him. If I try to move in, he's gonna step away, right? He's gonna step away. If he comes in, then yeah. So there's a distance game here. Okay? So now, learning to bridge the gap, now it becomes everything. You have to develop that skill, right? And do it in a safe way. All right, so that's what we're going to practice today. All right, so first, let's talk about the chi sao. Now, these guys are going to do double hand. Do double hand chi sao. Okay? Let's see how good they are. Okay? Okay, it's not too bad. Not bad at all, right? Okay, so they're relaxed, okay? Now, first, we do chi sao. We do chi sao to develop our sensitivity and to develop our body structure, right? Okay? And yeah, they're doing hien sao and they're changing position, which is a good thing to do. We'll talk about that in another video, right? Which is good. Good. Okay, stop. All right? Now, if we're in the ring, okay, and we're going to compete, and then they ding the bell, right, ding, we don't go like this, okay, right, this is not going to happen, right?
Jim's got the upper tongue.
All right, and I always tell these guys, you have to think of yourself like a grappler, okay, think of yourself like a grappler, who doesn't know anything else, just the grappling, okay, because I really consider Wing Chun stand-up grappling, okay. People will argue with me a lot about this, but it doesn't matter, okay? It's just my own opinion. It's like stand-up grappling. Now, my point is that if I'm just a grappler, okay, and let's say Mike is a kickboxer, right, a Muay Thai, right, MMA guy, right, okay? Now, for me, I have to get him to play my grappling game. That means I have to get close enough so that I can grab him. Now I can play. He's in my game. He's playing my game now, right? Single leg, double leg, right? Okay. When a grappler can get close like that, then I'm forcing the kickboxer or the Muay Thai guy to play my grappling game. Okay. If his skills are better than mine, and every time I go to grapple, he kicks me. Boom, or he knees me, bam, or he punches me, bam, and I go, whoa, okay? Now, I can't close, I can't get close, so now I'm playing his game, right? So now my skills as a grappler become very almost non-existent in that scenario, right? And you see that in the mixed martial arts. That's how come a lot of them now are trying to get a more well-rounded game so that if they are caught and they can't get close, then at least they have something to fall back on, okay? Which is smart, all right? But I want you to think of yourself, if you're practicing Chinese martial arts, if you're practicing Wing Chun, Chinese boxing, you have to think of yourself like a grappler. You have to get the other guy to play your game. What's our game? Our game is Chi Sao. Right? So you go, how do I get a fighter to play that game? Right? Okay? So first thing is you got to close. All right, so we're going to practice closing. All right? So, come here, Brian. Brian with a Y. Okay, so Brian's going to be the striker. So he's going to come up and his hands are up. Okay? Mike's hands are up, right? And it can be up, closed, comfortable, relaxed, okay? Your hand position should be comfortable, okay? It doesn't, not so stiff, right? No rigid, right? Yeah. Okay? Right? So stay relaxed, all right? So keep your hands up. Now Mike is, now Brian, okay, is gonna come in and he's going to lead jab. Now, a couple things I want you to practice, okay? Now, keep your hands up. Now, Brian's going to lead jab. Go ahead. Okay? Yeah, now. Okay? Now, go back. Now, put your hands to your side. Now, Brian's okay, going to punch you. Okay? Now. Now, don't move. I'm kidding. Okay? But, okay, I want, you have to train right. Okay? So, if Brian's going to jab, lead jab, go ahead, lead jab, step in. See? No, okay? I want you to step in. Get into a space. Go. Hands up. A jab. Yeah, okay? So Brian is practicing a couple things. When you partner up with and you guys practice this, okay? First thing is don't pose. Okay, don't pose. What do I mean? Okay? Brian punches, lead jab, go ahead. Okay? And he stands like this for Mike to do anything he wants now. Yeah, okay. This is posing. Okay? Or he throws a jab, and then he throws a cross, and then he poses right here. Right? Then he leaves it out for Mike to do whatever he wants. Right? Yeah. Okay? Don't pose. Why? Because you're depriving your partner of training. Okay? Because no one is going to leave their hand out for you. Okay? So if you're going to punch, make sure that you realistically try to step into that person's space. So that if I lead jab, right, I want to lead jab and step in so that if Mike doesn't move, and if I give him a little love tap, right, that's his own fault, okay? But at least I'm doing my part, okay? So very important that when I lead jab, I step in, okay? Yeah, that's also going to make him listen, step back, okay? The other thing is that when I lead jab, you want to return the fist back to your guarding position. For a boxer, that's always right back to his face. Okay, they're going to protect their hand, their cheek, their face, right? Their cheek, not this cheek. This cheek, right? So boxers don't do this, right? They protect the upper cheek. Right? So when you practice lead jab, you got to step in, punch straight out, right? And then bring it back right away. Okay, got it? So you want to practice with real intent, okay? But practice so that you don't hurt each other. Okay? You can also put on an MMA glove, a little bit safer. Put a boxing glove on, even safer, right? Okay? Mouthpiece. Okay, all right, now. But we're just going to develop this skill. Now, hands up. Now, we're going to go really slow for you, okay? So we're going to exaggerate this a little bit, slow it down, so that you can see what we're practicing. Okay, so now Brian is going to step in and lead jab. Go ahead. And as he does it, see Mike? Now, Mike is going to see how Brian's in long arm position. This is long arm. But you see Mike, he's still in that good angle. This is short arm. Okay? Right? This is ideal. Okay? That's another reason why you see Mike, he does a retreat step, a little retreat step. You can also go to the side, you can also go to either side. It doesn't matter. The important thing is that he is maintaining this bent elbow, okay? That's how come if he if it's sometimes dangerous if Brian punches and Mike steps in to block, see? Now he's in short arm range. Now this is sometimes dangerous for you, because now he's in, Brian also has that same advantage. He can reach, right? So, or he comes in, Brian comes in, and see this? Then Mike gets almost like he's stuck, see? And you're gonna see his arm gets really compressed to his body. You don't want this position, okay? So sometimes it's not good to go in, okay? Unless, of course, you're very, very athletic and you're fast, then you can do whatever you want, right? So when Brian comes in, Mike wants to maintain his structure. Chum Q is learning to maintain a moving structure. Silam Tao is learning to build the structure. Okay? So now, from here, Brian's gonna step in, Mike's gonna step out. You can use either hand, okay? Right? But it's very important that Mike does not overreach. Okay? In other words, when Brian comes in, right, and he steps back, right? But he overreaches. See? Now he's done what? He's broken that angle. Now he's also in long range, right? And he's also what? Sacrifice his structure. That's a no-no, okay? So that's how come he stays in that bent arm, all right? So you're going to practice. Brian is also going to retreat the hand and come back to a guard position. So, no, just cover, okay? Right? Okay? And then you're going to come back, all right? Now, that was good. Now, what you want to practice is follow the punch in. And I told you guys this is a skill that you guys have to acquire, right? So we're going to do this slow. Brian's going to punch, right? And see, Mike is going to follow. Mike is not pushing Brian's arm in. When Brian's hand comes back, he just follows it with his structure, with that bent arm. Okay? Got it? Now you go, what about this other hand, Jin? Well, of course, in Wing Chun, whenever there's nothing in your way, the hand does what? It should go straight. Okay? So when it goes straight, right, you should check this hand, check the shoulder, or attack his center line, right? Okay? So from here, Brian is only going to lead jab. So he's going to lead jab and bring the hand back, and Mike is going to follow that hand in. And see how he covers this hand, Brian's other hand? This is a good, this is right, okay? Now you're going to go back. Do it again. Step in, lead jab. Good. Okay? Now, you're going to step back too. You're going to retreat. Okay? That's going to force Mike to even follow you more. Okay? Yeah, see? Okay, good. I'm going to go back. All right? Now, once you get comfortable doing that, I want the other person to also throw the jab and the cross. Okay? So, Brian's going to throw the jab. Right? And then he's going to throw the cross, okay? So now, this is single hand. I'm doing danchi, okay? If I can stay with both hands, jab, and then cross, don't pose, right? Right? Then I'm going to stick to both hands, right? See what I mean by posing? Because if he does this, then I do something else, right? I do all my moves from here, right? I'm not learning to close, see? But when he jabs and he cross, right? And then he brings the hand back. See? It forces me to have to follow him in. That's why I said don't deprive your partner of training, okay? Bring your hands back just like a real boxer would do it, which is back to this guard position. Protect your face, right? Alright, practice. Again, jab and cross, Mike's going to follow him in. Yeah. Very important that you don't chase and overextend your angle when you're stepping in. Don't go like this, right? Then you're going to get nailed. Okay? Again. Yeah, that's it. Good. And don't worry if you lose contact with one hand for a brief moment. It's okay, right? You jab, and I lose contact I lose contact with that hand for just a minute, right? Then it's okay. I just catch up. Okay? Right? But just whatever you do, punch, don't go like this. I lose the contact, and then I reach. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay? And be aware of that other hand, right? Jab, I catch, and yeah, then I come in. Okay? So practice. One more. And across. Yeah. Okay? So this is the first skill you have to do. You have to get. All right? Now, you're in Chisa. Once you're in, you're playing Chisa now. Okay? The boxer is not going to let you do Chisa. Okay? So now, I'm going to be the boxer. And one at a time. Come here, Brian. Okay? So Brian's going to close in on me. Okay? All right? We'll go this way so they can actually get a better view of you. So from here, okay, I'm going to come in, jab, cross, right? Now, what I don't want to see is I jab and I cross and come in, right? And then you guys stop here. Because then what happens? You're giving the boxer the chance. If you just hold your position, then you're giving the boxer the chance to disengage and start. Now my hands are free. I don't want to play that Chi Sao game, okay? I want my hands free so I can attack. Okay? That's why it's very important that as soon as you get that touch, you play Chi Sao. That's how come I tell you guys, when you guys do Chi Sao, when does the game start? As soon as you touch. You can't go like this and go. Right? Forget it. Right? It's as soon as you guys touch, boom, the game starts. Right? The game starts right away. You develop that skill, and this is where it comes into play. Alright? So hands up. Alright? I'm gonna jab and cross. Okay? He's gonna follow me in. And then from here, he's gonna continue to play the Chi Sao game. Alright? Alright? So I come in. Right? Yeah. Okay? And you notice when he gets into my space, he's bent armed. His arm is still bent. He's invading my space, my territory. Step in, right? And now he shoots the basketball.
Go ahead.
Right? So, it's safe. I didn't get hurt. Okay. I always tell them it's like having a gun. But see, the most important thing is that his whole body is in. Okay. His whole body is in. He had his arms. They can still extend. He hasn't. It's like having a gun. Right? Like this. And I come in, you parry my gun, right? And then I come in, right? See? And I'm like this. I can fire. If I want to fire, I can fire. Right? I can hurt him. But I don't do it. Okay? Okay? Then we train again. That way you guys don't hurt each other, right? I see so much bad Chi Sao. Chi Sao and Wing Chun, the focus should not be so much on the offense. It should be on the defense. Right? I'll probably get also a lot of complaints about this one. But it's my own opinion. Alright? It's your defensive skills that you need to practice. Alright? And learning to get, at the same time, your whole body into that person's space. Right? I guess you could say practice your defense with your offense, because your both hands are working. Right? But getting into a position where if you wanted to fire, you could really hurt him, but you don't. That's really what I'm talking about. Okay? Being able to get into a offensive setup while at the same time in a very safe manner, okay, with a strong defense. All right, so again, now, all I'm doing is the jab and the cross, okay? And I'm forcing Brian to come in, and then once he's in, now he's going to play Chi Sao. Now, I don't want to play Chi Sao, right? Okay, there's a lot of things that a boxer or wrestler or grappler are going to do, right? Okay? This is where the Chi Sao, this is where you develop your skill. Sometimes they may want to try to run away. You have to stick to them. You have to force them to keep playing that game. Sometimes he comes in, right? And I push back. Then he's going to use shifting, right? Other, how to deal with, how he's going to play with that pressure. Okay? Right? Sometimes I'm going to try to attack him, right? This is important. I'm gonna jab and cross. I'm gonna keep attacking. Right. So I go jab and cross. Right. Yeah. So Brian doesn't know what I'm gonna do. Okay. So he has to respond through the pressure, through the touch. That's how come even up to this day, none of my students, none of you guys, I've never shown you guys a technique. I've never shown you guys. I punch and then you defend, right? Then I counter that with a with the lop, and then you counter that with a beel, and then you pull, and then I do this, and then you shift and you defend, right? Then you come back. Yeah, this is pointless. Who does that? You have to just trust the concepts, trust your training, relax your arms, and your pressure, your body will find a way. It will always find a way if you adhere to the concepts. Okay? So, I jab it across, right? See, I'm trying to look. Yeah. And he's doing a good job maintaining that forward pressure. Okay? And then playing. See, if I retreat, he's going to keep following me. Okay? And then once he gets into my master bedroom, right, then he should extend. Right? So, yeah. And then extend. Okay? Practice like that. All right, Mike, come here. All right? So, then you just play. Right? From here, I'm going to jab my cross. And then he doesn't know what else I'm going to do. Right? So I come in. Right? I mean, try to kick him. See? Yeah. I can kick him. Why? Because he's letting the pressure off. Okay? But if I go like this and I go, how do I kick him now? Right? If I lift that foot, he's gonna toss me. Right? Over here, right? Right? Yeah. Overcut, whatever. Okay? But you have to learn to extend, both of you guys. Right? Right? So he let me go, right? Ooh, I felt like, I can keep going, right? So, practice, right? So, come on, Brian. Okay? So Brian's going to jab and cross, right? Right?
Yeah.
That's it. Simple. He comes in. He may try to do something else. Doesn't matter to me. Okay, that's it. Nice. Okay, that's it. See, my pressure doesn't allow him to finish the move. Now, if I go like this, and then he hooks. Right? No. And hook. And I go like this. Oh my God! Yeah. Okay. See, I'm chasing his hand. No. But if he goes jab cross and he goes hook, see, I go in. His hook becomes useless. See? You never chase the technique. That's called chasing hands. Alright. Huh? Show. Big hole. Right? And see, we're not hurting each other. But it's so important that as soon as you get the touch, don't pose. As soon as you get the touch, right, you play chi-sao right away. I don't wait around. I play chi-sao right away, right? Play the chi-sao game. You force the guy to play chi-sao, okay? They're not going to want to play chi-sao. They're going to want to do what? Free their arms, tackle you, take you to the ground. They're going to try to get closer to you, or they're going to try to pull away from you, right? Or they're going to try to move side with you. You have to learn this. People, everyone knows Chum Q is about building the bridge. And that's an important skill to learn. But what they forget is they have to learn to maintain the bridge. You have to force the unwilling partner to play this game. Right? Peace out. You have to learn, you have to get them to want to play that game, right? You got to get them, see, to play the game they don't want to play, right? That's how come people, MMA guys, boxers, grapplers, they watch Wing Chun on YouTube, and I just shake my head, because they all go, who does this? And they're right. Okay, and then they see all the horrible Wing Chun in their sparring against other martial arts like grapplers and kickboxers and boxers, right? And it looks horrible. It looks because they can't even they they can't even bridge and maintain their structure. And then if they do, they lose the bridge immediately, and then they get plowed, right? It's like doing chisaw like this, right? But then I do it really, really, really loose, right? Right? That's horrible. It's like doing good chisaw, and then all of a sudden I let off. Yeah. So it's like building the bridge. Punch. I build the bridge, right? And then I let off. Oh my God! I'm gonna get nailed. Okay? They don't. They learn to bridge. They don't learn to maintain the bridge. Okay? And that to me is so important, especially if you want to go into the ring, especially if you want to go into the cage. And you want to use your skills against other martial artists, right? So continue to practice. Practice safe. Nobody got hurt. Did you get hurt? Get hurt? Did I get hurt?
Yeah.
I always get hurt. All right? So keep practicing, and that's it, right? Thank you very much, and we'll talk to you soon.